Thank you, Chris Hampton. My name is Calum McInnes, and I'm a PhD student in CT19 within the Structures Research Team in the Bristol Composites Institute. And this morning, I'm going to present my recent project work looking at the continuous tow shearing process to improve the dynamic performance of thin walled cylinders under vibration loading. So, why an interest in thin walled cylinders? Well, thin walled cylinders have numerous applications in aerospace design, with next generation aerospace vehicles requiring lightweight structures to enable sustainable transport and improve performance. And as I mentioned previously, this project looked at the continuous tow shearing process, or CTS process, to improve the performance of these cylinders. The CTS process steers material tows along a curvilinear reference path by shearing the material in plane. And as you shear material in plane, you're going to get an out of plane thickness increase, which can be exploited in a design setting. So if we're looking to design a cylinder, we have two intuitive steering directions. We can either steer the toes axially along the cylinder's longitudinal axis, or we can steer circumferentially around the circumference. So in a design setting, we can introduce periodicity to the steering. So as you can see in the two figures here, on the left, if we were to steer in the axial direction periodically, we can embed circumferentially aligned pseudo hoops. And likewise, if we steer circumferentially, we can embed pseudo stringers in the longitudinal direction. So in order to look at the potential performance benefits the CTS process can give us in design setting, a number of cylinders were simulated under free boundary conditions in Abacus. And as you can see here, the mode shape that arises when the structure is at resonance is dominated by radial deformations. And from this, we can infer a preferred steering direction to the structure. So this means that because we're deforming the radial direction, the structure tends to prefer the axial steering to embed those pseudo hoops, which act to increase the circumferential stiffness components of the structure and resist that radial deformation. And it was found that corresponds to an approximate 40% increase in performance, which is quite substantial. So this was just a quick brief overview of my recent work, and I'd like to thank you all for your attention. And as Professor Hampton said, if there's any questions at all, please engage with me at my poster. So thank you.